casquette. Hat. Le chapeau. Le chapeau. Le chapeau. Scarf. Le foulard. Le foulard. Le foulard. Belt. La ceinture. La ceinture. La ceinture. Umbrella. Le parapluie. Le parapluie. Le parapluie. Gloves. Les gants. Les gants. Les gants. Tie pin. L'épingle de cravate. L'épingle de cravate. L'épingle de cravate. Handkerchief. Le mouchoir. Le mouchoir. Le mouchoir. Seafood. Les fruits de mer. Les fruits de mer. Les fruits de mer. Cuttlefish. La sèche. La sèche. La sèche. Squid. Le calamar. Le calamar. Le calamar. Razor shell clam. Le couteau. Le couteau. Le couteau. Mussel. La moule. La moule. La moule. Shrimp. La crevette. La crevette. La crevette. Lobster. Le homard. Le homard. Le homard. Scallop. La coquille Saint-Jacques. La coquille Saint-Jacques. La coquille Saint-Jacques. Crab. Le crabe. Le crabe. Le crabe. Crayfish, l'écrevisse. 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 The seasons and the climates. Les saisons et les climats. Les saisons et les climats. Les saisons et les climats. Continental climate. Le climat continental. Le climat continental. Le climat continental. Fall. Autumn. L'automne. 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 Mediterranean climate. Le climat méditerranéen. Le climat méditerranéen. Le climat méditerranéen. Polar climate. Le climat polaire. Le climat polaire. Le climat polaire. Season. La saison. La saison. La saison. Spring. Le printemps. Le printemps. Le printemps. Summer. L'été. 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 Temperature climate. Le climat tempéré. Le climat tempéré. Le climat tempéré. Tropical climate. Le climat tropical. Le climat tropical. Le climat tropical. Winter, l'hiver. L'hiver, l'hiver. Sports, les sports. Les sports, les sports. Aerobics, l'aérobic. L'aérobic, l'aérobic. Alpine skiing, le ski alpin. Le ski alpin, le ski alpin. Basketball, le basket. Le basket, le basket. Biking, le cyclisme. Le cyclisme, le cyclisme. Bowling, le bowling. Le bowling, le bowling. Bungee jumping, le saut à l'élastique. Le saut à l'élastique. Le saut à l'élastique. Canoë, le canoë. Le canoë, le canoë. Climbing, l'escalade. L'escalade, l'escalade. Cross-country skiing, le ski de fond. Le ski de fond, le ski de fond. Diving, la plongée. La plongée, la plongée. Downhill race, la descente. La descente, la descente. Figure skating, le patinage artistique. Le patinage artistique. Le patinage artistique. Fishing, la pêche. La pêche, la pêche. Football, le football américain. Le football américain, le football américain. Golf, le golf. Le golf, le golf. Gymnastics, la gymnastique. La gymnastique, la gymnastique. Handball, le handball. Le handball, le handball. Hiking, la randonnée. La randonnée, la randonnée. Hockey, le hockey. Le hockey, le hockey. Horseback riding, l'équitation. L'équitation, l'équitation. Ice skate, le patin à glace. Le patin à glace. Le patin à glace. Jet ski, le jet ski. Le jet ski, le jet ski. Jogging, le jogging. Le jogging, le jogging. Judo, le judo. Le judo, le judo. Karaté, le karaté. Le karaté, le karaté. Kayak, le kayak. Le kayak, le kayak. Kitesurfing, le kitesurf. Le kitesurf, kitesurf, le kitesurf. Luge, la luge. La luge, la luge. Mountain climbing, l'alpinisme. L'alpinisme, l'alpinisme. Outdoor bowling, la pétanque. La pétanque, la pétanque. Roller skate, le patin à roulettes. Le patin à roulettes. Le patin à roulettes. Rowing, l'aviron. L'aviron, l'aviron. Rugby, le rugby. Le rugby, le rugby. Running, le footing. Le footing, le footing. Sailing, la voile. La voile, la voile. Skateboard, le skateboard. Le skateboard, le skateboard. Ski jumping, le saut à ski. Le saut à ski. Le saut à ski. Skydiving, le vol libre. Le vol libre. Le vol libre. Soccer, le foot. Le foot. Le foot. Speed skating, le patinage de vitesse. Le patinage de vitesse. Le patinage de vitesse. Surfing, le surf. Le surf. Le surf. Swimming, la natation. La natation. La natation. Tennis, le tennis. Le tennis. Le tennis. Underwater diving, la plongée sous-marine. La plongée sous-marine. La plongée sous-marine. Volleyball, le volley. Le volley. Le volley. Walking, la marche. La marche. La marche. Water skiing, le ski nautique. Le ski nautique. Le ski nautique. Weight lifting, la musculation. La musculation. La musculation. Windsurfing, la planche à voile. La planche à voile. La planche à voile. Skeleton, le squelette. Le squelette. Le squelette. Tibia, le tibia. Le tibia. Le tibia. Fémur, le fémur. Le fémur. Le fémur. Metacarpal, le métacarpien. Le métacarpien. Le métacarpien. Rib cage, la cage thoracique. La cage thoracique. La cage thoracique. Humerus, l'humérus, l'humérus, l'humérus. Jaw, la mâchoire, la mâchoire, la mâchoire. Skull, le crâne, le crâne, le crâne. Collarbone, la clavicule, la clavicule, la clavicule. Shoulder blade, l'omoplate, l'omoplate, l'omoplate. Breastbone, le sternum, le sternum, le sternum. Rib, la côte, la côte, la côte. Ulna, le cubitus, le cubitus, le cubitus. Radius, le radius, le radius, le radius. Pelvis, le bassin, le bassin, le bassin. Kneecap, la rotule, la rotule, la rotule. Fibula, le péroné, le péroné, le péroné. Tailbone, le coccyx, le coccyx, le coccyx. Lumbar vertebra, les lombaires, les lombaires, les lombaires. Cervical vertebra, les vertèbres cervicales, les vertèbres cervicales, les vertèbres cervicales. Spine, la colonne vertébrale, la colonne vertébrale, la colonne vertébrale. Joint, l'articulation, l'articulation, l'articulation. Tendon, le tendon, le tendon, le tendon. Bone, l'os, l'os, l'os. Ligament, le ligament, le ligament, le ligament. Cartilage, le cartilage, le cartilage, le cartilage. Stages of life, les étapes de la vie, les étapes de la vie, les étapes de la vie. Newborn, le nouveau-né, le nouveau-né, le nouveau-né. Baby, le bébé, le bébé, le bébé. Child, l'enfant, l'enfant, l'enfant. Boy, le garçon, le garçon, le garçon. Girl, la fille, la fille, la fille. Teenager, l'adolescente, l'adolescente, l'adolescente. Teenager, l'adolescent. L'adolescent, l'adolescent. Adult, l'adulte. L'adulte, l'adulte. Elderly person, la personne âgée. La personne âgée, la personne âgée. Old man, le vieil homme. Le vieil homme, le vieil homme. Old woman, la vieille femme. La vieille femme, la vieille femme. Deceased, le défunt. Le défunt, le défunt. Deceased, la défunte. La défunte, la défunte. Man, l'homme. L'homme, l'homme. Woman, la femme. La femme, la femme. Time, le temps. Learn French, present tense. She's very polite. Elle est très polie. Elle est très polie. Elle est très polie. She's generous. Elle est généreuse. Elle est généreuse. Elle est généreuse. She reaches out. Elle tend la main. Elle tend la main. Elle tend la main. She rejoices. Elle se réjouit. Elle se réjouit. Elle se réjouit. She's waving. Elle fait signe. Elle fait signe. Elle fait signe. She cries sometimes. Elle pleure parfois. Elle pleure parfois. Elle pleure parfois. She is disappointed. Elle est déçue. Elle est déçue. Elle est déçue. She likes to win. Elle aime gagner. Elle aime gagner. Elle aime gagner. She is strong. Elle est forte. Elle est forte. Elle est forte. She flies in her dreams. Elle vole dans ses rêves. Elle vole dans ses rêves. Elle vole dans ses rêves. She sometimes feels bad. Elle se sent parfois mal. Elle se sent parfois mal. Elle se sent parfois mal. She loves to drive. Elle adore conduire. Elle adore conduire. Elle adore conduire. She's rarely sad. Elle est rarement triste. Elle est rarement triste. Elle est rarement triste. She falls sometimes. Elle tombe parfois. Elle tombe parfois. Elle tombe parfois. She feels bad. Elle se sent mal. Elle se sent mal. Elle se sent mal. She is positive. Elle est positive. Elle est positive. Article en fourrure. Pelleterie. Vêtements en fourrure. Article en fourrure synthétique. Fourrure. À l'intérieur. À l'extérieur. Accessoires de bureau. Accessoires pour classeur ou fichier. Crochet et œillet. Articles religieux. Aménagements divers. Fournitures pour blanchisserie. Tableau noir. Éponge à effacer pour tableau noir. Ardoise d'écolier. Instrument de dessin. Instrument d'écriture. Règles. Produits artificiels. Fruits artificiels. Fleurs artificielles. Gazon artificiel. Pelouse artificielle. Bijouterie de fantaisie. Appareils et équipements de démonstration. Produits d'information et de promotion. Accessoires d'habillement. Mouchoir. Écharpe. Cravate. Gants. Gants jetables. Moufle. Gants à crispin. Ceinture. Cartouchière.
Verbe, bercer, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent. Je berce. Tu berces. Il berce. Nous berçons. Vous bercez. Il berce. Verbe. Berner. Mode. Indicatif. Temps. Présent. Je berne. Tu bernes. Il berne. Nous bernons. Vous bernez. Il berne. Verbe, boire, mode.
Indicatif, temps, passé composé.
J'ai bu.
Tu as bu.
Il a bu.
Nous avons bu.
Vous avez bu.
Ils ont bu.
Au revoir et à bientôt.
Verbe, boire, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
Je bois.
Tu bois.
Il boit.
Nous buvons.
Vous buvez.
Ils boivent.
Verbe, boire, mode. Indicatif, temps, passé composé.
J'ai bu.
Tu as bu.
Il a bu.
Nous avons bu.
Vous avez bu.
Ils ont bu.
Verbe, bouillir, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
Je boue.
Tu boues.
Il boue.
Nous bouillons.
Vous bouillez.
Il bouille.
Verbe, bouillir, mode. Indicatif, temps, passé composé.
J'ai bouilli.
Tu as bouilli.
Il a bouilli.
Nous avons bouilli.
Vous avez bouilli.
Ils ont bouilli.
Verbe, brimballer, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
Je brimballe.
Tu brimballes.
Il brimballe.
Nous brimballons.
Vous brimballez.
Il brimballe.
Verbe, broyer, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
Je broie.
Tu broies.
Il broie.
Nous broyons.
Vous broyez.
Il broie.
Verbe, broyer, mode. Indicatif, temps, passé composé.
J'ai broyé.
Tu as broyé.
Il a broyé.
Nous avons broyé.
Vous avez broyé.
Ils ont broyé.
Verbe, cavaler, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
Je cavale.
Tu cavales.
Il cavale.
Nous cavalons.
Vous cavalez.
Il cavale.
Verbe. Céder. Mode. Indicatif. Temps. Présent.
Je cède.
Tu cèdes.
Il cède.
Nous cédons.
Vous cédez.
Il cède.
Verbe. Aboutir. Mode. Indicatif. Temps. Présent.
J'aboutis.
Tu aboutis.
Il aboutit.
Nous aboutissons.
Vous aboutissez.
Ils aboutissent.
Verbe. Absoudre. Mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
J'absous.
Tu absous.
Il absout.
Nous absolvons.
Vous absolvez.
Ils absolvent.
Verbe, absoudre, mode. Indicatif, temps, passé composé.
J'ai absous.
Tu as absous.
Il a absous.
Nous avons absous.
Vous avez absous.
Ils ont absous.
Verbe. Abuser. Mode. Indicatif. Temps. Présent.
J'abuse.
Tu abuses.
Il abuse.
Nous abusons.
Vous abusez.
Ils abusent.
Verbe. Acquérir. Mode. Indicatif. Temps. Présent.
J'acquiers.
Tu acquiers.
Il acquiert.
Nous acquérons.
Vous acquérez.
Ils acquièrent.
Verbe, acquérir, mode. Indicatif, temps. Passé composé.
J'ai acquis.
Tu as acquis.
Il a acquis.
Nous avons acquis.
Vous avez acquis.
Ils ont acquis.
Verbe, affectionner, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
J'affectionne.
Tu affectionnes.
Il affectionne.
Nous affectionnons.
Vous affectionnez.
Ils affectionnent.
Verbe, agir, mode. Indicatif, temps, présent.
J'agis.
Tu agis.
Il agit.
Nous agissons.
Vous agissez.
Ils agissent.
Imagier.net présente Agrafé volume 1. Des agrafes. Une agrafeuse. Une agrafeuse long bras. Une agrafeuse brocheuse. Un autagrafe. Une pince agrafeuse. Une agrafeuse électrique. Imagier.net présente Conditionnement, volume 1. Des pochettes matelassées. Une bobine de film étirable. Des cartons. Un rouleau de carton ondulé. Une plieuse à courrier. Des ficelles. Du papier craft. Un sac cabas. Des rouleaux à bulles. Du papier cadeau. Un sac cabas en craft. Imagier.net présente Dans la maison, volume 1. Un lit futon. Un tiroir à roulettes. Une table de chevet. Un coussin tête de lit. Une armoire penderie. Une commode. Imagier.net présente Dans la maison, volume 3. Une chaise. Une table basse. Un fauteuil. Une table. Une table basse. Une étagère. Un tapis. Une bibliothèque. Un cadre décoratif. Une lampe de chevet. Un panier de rangement. Un cadre bougeoir. Imagier.net présente Dans la maison, volume 4. Une table basse. Un range CD.
Une bibliothèque.
Une étagère.
Un buffet.
Un coffre. Imagier.net présente Dans la maison, volume 4. Une table basse.
Un range CD.
Une bibliothèque.
Une étagère.
Un buffet.
Un coffre.
Imagier.net présente Découper, volume 1. Une cisaille.
Des rogneuses de précision.
Une rogneuse.
Une rogneuse portable.
Un cutter.
Une lame pour cutter.
Un massicot.
Un taille-crayon.
Un cutter pliable.
Un cutter rotatif.
Une paire de ciseaux.
Des ciseaux pour enfants.
Des ciseaux pour matériaux récalcitrants.
Un taille-crayon électrique.
Un scalpel.
Un ouvre-carton.
Un taille-crayon en métal. Imagier.net présente Écriture, volume 1.
Un stylo bille bleu.
Un stylo bille rouge.
Un stylo bille noir.
Un stylo bille vert.
Un stylo bille quatre couleurs.
Un porte-plume.
Un stylo-plume.
Un stylo-bille rétractable.
Un stylo à encre gel.
Des cartouches pour stylo à plume.
Des plumes.
Un porte-mine.
De l'encre de Chine.
Un stylo roller.
Un crayon graphite.
Des feutres.
Un stylo feutre bleu.
Un stylo feutre vert.
Un stylo feutre rose.
Un stylo feutre rouge.
Un feutre bleu.
Un feutre noir.
Un feutre rouge.
Un marqueur.
Des marqueurs de couleur.
Un surligneur.
Un correcteur fluide.
Un mini-roller de correction.
Un roller de correction.
Une gomme.
Un stylo-gomme.
Une gomme encre-crayon.
Le garçon gourmand.
Le garçon
Le chien. Le pichet. Les biscuits. Le beurre. La nappe. Le marchepied. Le maître nageur. Les cheveux. L'œil. L'oreille. La main. Le pied. Le ballon. Le sifflet. La bouée. La bouche. Le nombril. Le rocker. Les cheveux. Le nez. L'oreille. La boucle d'oreille. La langue. Les dents. La main. L'épaule. Le coude. Le cou. Le dos. Le visage. Le nez. L'œil. La bouche. Le menton. L'oreille. La joue. Le front. Les cheveux. Les sourcils. Le visage. Le nez. L'œil. La bouche. Le
Le menton. L'oreille. La joue. Le front. Les sourcils. Le visage. Le nez. L'œil. La bouche. Le menton. L'oreille. La joue. Le front. Les sourcils. Les cheveux. Le visage. Les cheveux. Le front. L'œil. Les yeux. Les sourcils. L'oreille. Le nez. La bouche. La mâchoire. Le menton. Les directions. À gauche. À droite. En haut. En bas. Répétons. À gauche. À droite. En haut. En bas. Les points cardinaux. L'ouest. L'est. Le nord. Le sud. Répétons. L'ouest. L'est. Le nord. Le sud. Les verbes. Sortir du four. Lire le journal. Ramasser ses billes.
Servir des bières.
Regarder dans une boule de cristal.
Souffler dans un sifflet.
Cuisiner.
Préparer un sandwich.
Sortir un pain du four.
Couper une meule de fromage.
Planter un clou.
Couper une planche de bois.
Les verbes.
Faire le ménage.
Préparer une pizza.
Prendre des mesures.
Servir un plat.
Travailler.
Servir à boire.
Peindre.
Mener une enquête.
Lire.
Confectionner une robe.
Faire de la pâtisserie.
Couper les cheveux.
Petit personnage.
Une chirurgienne.
Un chirurgien.
Une avocate.
Un juge.
Un maître nageur.
Une danseuse.
Un chimiste.
Un rocker.
Un politicien.
Un équilibriste.
Un agent secret.
Une actrice.
Une sportive.
Un garde du corps.
Un ange.
Un chèque.
Un archéologue.
Un architecte.
Un aventurier.
Un militaire.
Un peintre.
Une coiffeuse.
Un cuisinier.
Une danseuse.
Un joueur de banjo.
Un barbier.
Des vacanciers.
Un professeur.
Une baby-sitter.
Un aveugle.
Un sportif.
Un joueur de baseball.
Un garçon qui dessine.
Un footballeur.
Des scouts.
Un maçon.
Un voleur.
Des collègues.
Des copines.
Un boucher.
Un domestique.
Un serveur.
Un ébéniste.
Une fille qui dessine.
Un joueur de tam-tam.
Un couple préhistorique.
Un conducteur de char.
Des personnes âgées.
Un musicien.
Un fakir.
Une pom-pom girl.
Une cuisinière.
Un clown.
Un étudiant.
Une ouvrière.
Un chanteur.
Un policier.
Des amoureux.
Des automobilistes.
Un cow-boy.
Un cavalier.
Un fou.
Une écolière.
Un inspecteur.
Un réalisateur.
Une danseuse.
Un scaphandrier.
Un docteur.
Un sorcier.
Des paysans.
Un esquimau.
Un bourreau.
Des pique-niqueurs.
Des fermiers.
Un agriculteur.
Une infirmière.
Une maître nageuse.
Une surfeuse.
Une plongeuse.
Une nageuse.
Un violoniste.
Un pompier.
Un politicien.
Un jardinier.
Une lectrice.
Une acrobate.
Une cycliste.
Une vaïnée.
Une marchande de glace.
Une adolescente.
Une écolière.
Une patineuse.
Un guerrier.
Une femme âgée.
Des musiciens.
Des plongeurs.
Un peintre en bâtiment.
Un adolescent.
Une voyante.
Une campeuse.
Une mécanicienne.
Un modéliste.
Un campeur.
Un professeur.
Un balayeur.
Un juge.
Un juge.
Un jongleur.
Un roi.
Des joueurs de Scrabble.
Un fumeur.
Une présentatrice.
Une bibliothécaire.
Un maître nageur.
Un pianiste.
Un bûcheron.
Un magicien.
Un détective.
Une femme de chambre.
Un livreur.
Un facteur.
Un malade.
Un travailleur à la chaîne.
Un déménageur.
Un lecteur.
Un couple.
Un joueur de maracas.
Un guitariste.
Un trompettiste.
Un génie.
Un mécanicien.
Un plongeur.
Un militaire.
Un livreur de lait.
Un mime.
Un garagiste.
Un homme invisible.
Un Amérindien.
Une Amérindienne.
Un snowboarder.
Un skieur.
Des danseurs.
Un chanteur d'opéra.
Un Égyptien.
Un pirate.
Un plombier.
Un président.
Une princesse.
Un détective.
Un professeur.
Un psychologue.
Une reine.
Un chanteur.
Un rasta.
Un homme chauve.
Un rocker.
Un patineur.
Un grec.
Un couvreur.
Un super-héros.
Un marin.
Un samouraï.
Le Père Noël.
Un cancre.
Une institutrice.
Un philosophe grec.
Une plongeuse.
Un garde du corps.
Un sommelier.
Un écrivain.
Un malade.
Un astronaute.
Un coureur.
Un karatéka.
Un joueur de frisbee.
Un plongeur.
Un tailleur.
Un couturier.
Un présentateur de télévision.
Un cycliste.
Des amoureux sur un banc.
Une équilibriste.
Un guitariste.
Un photographe.
Un trapéziste.
Un agent secret.
Un reporter.
Un guerrier.
Un baigneur.
Un journaliste.
Un vétérinaire.
Un serveur.
Un sorcier.
Une artiste peintre.
Une joueuse de badminton.
Une cycliste.
Une sage-femme.
Une femme enceinte.
Une sculptrice.
Une employée de bureau.
Une femme qui se maquille.
Une architecte.
Une femme avec les yeux bandés.
Un serveur.
Un guerrier.
Une randonneuse.
Elle est furieuse.
Elle est en larmes.
Elle est rieuse.
Elle est souriante.
Elle est déçue.
Elle est choquée.
Elle est espiègle.
Elle est complice.
Elle est heureuse.
Il joue du violon.
Il a mis un masque.
Il est heureux.
Il fait une confidence.
Il fait de la boxe.
Il joue au docteur.
Il fait de la moto.
Il joue du saxophone.
Il est incognito.
Il se repose sur le fauteuil.
Il a bien mangé.
Il joue de la trompette.
Il fait de l'escrime.
Il joue aux mousquetaires.
Il est surpris.
Il est déçu.
Il est contrarié.
Il est étonné.
Il est perplexe.
Il est heureux.
Il est farceur.
Il est choqué.
Il fait un clin d'œil.
Il est heureux.
Il fait la tête.
Il tire la langue.
Il est triste.
Il est soucieux.
Il est content.
Il est choqué.
Il fait un clin d'œil.
Avant de commencer, so before we start learning French together, I just wanted to actually tell you something, and it's the fact that French language and English language, well, they've got a special relationship. The first thing that, of course, you probably know, like many other languages, French tend to take quite many new words from English, so these are called les néologismes, okay? So it does mean that you already know quite many words in French. When we're talking about the new words, of course, you will have to pronounce them a bit differently. And the second thing that you should keep in mind, maybe you don't know that already, but until the 14th century, approximately 10,000 words were introduced into English language, and they were coming from French and Norman. So what does it mean? It does mean that you know a lot, and really I mean a lot, of French words already if you master English. If it's your mother tongue, then it's quite good for you. If it's not your mother tongue, then you will encounter, while we do these this series of videos, many words that you already know because you've been learning them already in English. Okay, so this is the thing, and well, just wanted to start with that. Keep in mind that you already know quite many words in French before you even start learning it. Okay, but now we will start with a serious thing, and we will start learning French.
Le garçon gourmand. Le garçon. Le chien. Le pichet. Les biscuits. Le beurre. La nappe. Le marchepied.
La structure de la phrase. So the structure of the sentence in French. Okay, so you'll see that in a way it's not that different from English, because we are using English here to study and for me to teach. So it means that for us it will be quite nice, because in a way French language will actually work or behave in a way similar to English. So first, normally, will come the subject, le sujet. Then you will put the verb, le verbe. And after that will come what we call les compléments. Okay, so this is the normal structure of a sentence. You start with the subject, then will come the verb, and after that you will complete the sentence with more information, so basically des compléments. Okay, so let's see now an example. Je suis français. Okay, je, I, so it's the subject here. Suis, so it's to be, you conjugate it. I am français, in that case it's an adjective and it's French. Okay, je suis français. So it goes in that order. You will start with the subject, then you will put the verb. You can see that the verb is conjugated here, so you will have to modify it according to the subject. And then after that you will put more informations, adjectives, or then well, other things if you want. And then a second example. Tu habites en France. Okay, tu, it's you. Habite, the verb is habiter, and then you conjugate it here. Habiter is to live. En France, in France. Okay, so you can see that in that case, it's what we call complément de lieu. Okay, you introduce a place here. Tu habites en France. Okay, so, but then we keep the same order, because that's normally the way we should do it. So first the subject, then the verb. Same thing here, you conjugate it according to tu, and after that, in that case, you will put en France. All right, so this is what we call a normal sentence, une phrase normale. Okay, but then, of course, as usual in French, and this is something that you will discover with all these videos that I will make, we've got some exceptions possible, and then the modifications, you can modify the sentences in some cases. Okay, but then this is the basic, okay? You should keep in mind that first you will put the subject, then the verb is coming, and after that, les compléments. Le sujet, le verbe, les compléments. Je suis français. Tu habites en France. And that's it.
Le maître nageur. Les cheveux. L'œil. L'oreille. La main. Le pied. Le ballon. Le sifflet. La bouée. La bouche. Le nombril.
Les phrases simples, so simple sentences. And we'll see that right now. So, les phrases simples in French language are la phrase interrogative, la phrase affirmative, la phrase négative, la phrase exclamative, la phrase impérative. Okay? So, la phrase interrogative, interrogative sentence, la phrase affirmative, affirmative sentence, la phrase négative, negative sentence, la phrase exclamative, exclamation, la phrase impérative, imperative sentence. And we'll start, of course, with the first one. So for each type of sentence, I will put an example. Okay, so let's start with la phrase interrogative. Aimez-vous le fromage? Okay, so the first thing that you should notice is this point d'interrogation here, and then keep in mind that in French we will put a space before. Okay, the second thing that you can notice is that you've got the verb here, aimer, aimer is to like or to love, and then you will have this vous, so it's the you, okay, and it's the plural form, aimez-vous, do you like, do you love, le fromage, so it's cheese, of course, it's a question that a French person could ask, you know, do you love cheese, do you like cheese? And, well, the first thing, or the second, because the first one was le point d'interrogation, the second thing that you could notice is that if we want to respect the rule when we ask a question, we should change the order of the sentence. So normally in French, we've got first the subject, then the verb. But when we ask a question like that, and we want to, well, respect the rule, then we should first put the verb, then the subject. Okay, I will make some videos explaining how it works in real situations, or if this is the way that people do normally when they ask a question. Okay, but this is the way it should be done. Okay, so this is a question, c'est une phrase interrogative. Aimez-vous le fromage? Aimez-vous le fromage. And remember, you need to raise your voice a little bit at the end. Aimez-vous le fromage? Phrase affirmative. Oui, j'aime le fromage. So in that case, you just want to say that you like or you love cheese. And then this is affirmative. You will start with oui here. Oui, j'aime le fromage. Okay, so you can see that in that case, you will use this je. Okay, I will explain in the next video why the e is disappearing here. But then it's I like, I love. Okay, oui, j'aime le fromage. So you keep the same order, subject and then verb. Okay, so the order that actually normally we've got in the French language, you will start with the subject and after that the verb is coming. La phrase négative. Okay, so in that case, you want to say non. Okay, non, je n'aime pas le fromage. No, I don't like cheese. Okay, and in that case, well, we'll see that a bit later as well. You will use this ne and then pas. So basically, when we introduce the negative form in French, we will have two parts that will be before and after the verb. Okay, non, je n'aime pas le fromage. La phrase impérative. Mangeons ce fromage. Okay, and in that case, you can see quite clearly that you've got what we call le point d'exclamation here at the end. Keep in mind that you should put a space before it. Okay, so point d'exclamation, and normally it means that you will use that whether to give an order. In most of the cases, it will be for an order, or then if you want to give an advice, it's possible as well. Okay, and in that case, mangeons, so it's at the new form. Okay, so we eat. Okay, so let's eat, but then in that case, it could be an order, so eat this cheese. Okay, you can see that we will see when we'll discover l'impérative form together that this nous, so the subject, is not here. It's something quite special for the imperative form. You take away les pronoms personnels. Mangeons ce fromage. Okay, and in that case, this sentence is une phrase impérative. Phrase exclamative. And in that case, it's actually interesting because it's so short. And in a way, it's a sentence even if you don't have any verb. Because here, quel, what, and then bon, good, fromage. So one more time, cheese. What a good cheese, quel bon fromage. Okay, it's a sentence, but then clearly you don't have any verb. Okay, so it means that in some cases, like this one, for instance, you can have sentences without having a verb in them. Okay, and it's here in phrase exclamative, quel bon fromage. Le sujet. And we'll see actually in this video what in French can be subject of a sentence. Okay, le sujet, the subject. And basically it can be un nom, un pronom interrogatif, un pronom indéfini. Okay, so when we're talking about, when we're talking about a subject, it can be un nom, and it's a noun, un pronom personnel, and it's a subject pronoun, un pronom interrogatif, interrogative pronoun, or then un pronom indéfini, indefinite pronoun. And we'll see, and we'll of course start with the first one, un nom. Okay, so let's start with un nom. And I just wanted to have a simple sentence in that case. And it will be Vincent enseigne le français. Okay, so Vincent is a first name, and it's mine, by the way. Enseigne, here you've got a verb. So the verb is enseigner, and it's conjugated in that case. Le français, so it's French, and we're referring to French language. Vincent enseigne le français. And in this sentence, you can see quite easily that Vincent here is the subject of the verb here. Okay, so we could also change this Vincent, take it away, and then put le professeur, and it means the teacher, and it will stay also the subject of the sentence, so it's connected directly to the verb enseigner here. Le sujet peut être un pronom personnel, so it can be also a subject pronoun as we saw. So let's see now how it would go. And in that case, same thing, simple sentence to start. Il visite Paris. Okay, so you get il here, I-L, visite. This is the verb visiter, you conjugate it. Il visite Paris. So in that case, you can see also quite easily that this is the subject of the sentence, and it's what we call un pronom personnel. So in English, it's more clear because it's subject pronoun, so no doubt about the function. And actually, we'll discover them together. So the first one is je, I, tu, you, il, he, elle, she. Okay, so je, tu, il, elle. And then for the plural form, we have nous, we, vous, you. So for the plural form, as in English, we tend to use it, well, of course, for the plural form, and also for the polite form. If you meet someone for the first time, it would be nice to use vous instead of tu. Il, they, so it's the masculine in that case, and then elle, they, but it's the feminine in that case. So in French, we make the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form when we use les pronoms personnels at the plural. Okay, so eux, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. All right. And so let's see now un pronom interrogatif. So same thing, simple structure, simple sentence, and the sentence is qui parle? So it's a question, okay? So the verb is parler, parler is to talk, okay? And then when you put this qui, and qui is who, basically this qui becomes, of course, the subject in this sentence, and it's a question. Who is talking? Qui parle? Qui parle? And the last one will be un pronom indéfini. And it's also quite useful, and I just wanted to make a simple sentence as well to make it clear. Same verb, parler is to talk, and then quelqu'un, someone, or somebody. Okay, and in that case, quelqu'un parle, somebody is talking, someone is talking, and in that case, you can see quite easily that quelqu'un is the subject of the sentence.
Le rocker, les cheveux, le nez,
L'oreille. La boucle d'oreille. La langue. Les dents. La main. L'épaule. Le coude. Le cou. Le dos.
Le sujet et le verbe. So, the subject and the verb. And it's actually quite important when we start to learn French, just to know that in French, basically, the subject will affect the verb. Okay? So, I just wanted to take a simple example first, because we will focus on the conjugation a bit later. So it's not the idea of this lesson. The idea of this lesson is just to show you that basically the relationship between the subject and the verb is quite close, because the verb will be affected by the subject. So the verb is marcher. Marcher is to walk. Okay, and let's take the example of il. Okay, so it's he. And basically, when you use il, you will have to conjugate the verb. So conjugate the verb means that for each form, you will have a specific ending. Okay, this is the basic form here, marcher. It's what we call the infinitive. All right, but then you don't reuse marcher just like that. You will have to conjugate it, so you will have to modify the ending according to the subject. In that case, il requires that you will put this final e here, so you will get il marche. All right, so whoops, sorry, the R is coming now. And then it will be exactly the same thing for the plural form of il. So they, il marche. And if you look carefully, the ending is different. Okay, we will see everything covering the conjugation a bit later. It's just to show you that the subject is basically affecting quite much the verb. Okay, and so when we're talking about this topic, basically it's quite good to have a general view of the conjugation of marcher, so how it will be modified according to the subject. So the first person, je, I, you will get je marche. Tu marches. Il, elle. Okay, so tu is for you, the singular form, and then il, he, elle, she. Marche. Nous marchons. So it's we, the plural form. Vous, you, the plural form. Marcher. And then il, oops, sorry, elle, and the plural, marche. So you can see that basically the forms are different, and it's one important thing that you've got to keep in mind, and that can be a bit tricky or difficult at the beginning, but then once you get used, you will remember the endings, okay? So basically, the subject will affect the verb, okay? And it was the topic of this video. Thank you.
visage.
Le nez.
L'œil.
La bouche.
Le menton.
L'oreille.
La joue.
Le front.
Les cheveux.
Les sourcils.
Les lettres. So the letters, and basically it is quite important because of course when you learn a language, well, you get to know the letters and you want to pronounce it correctly. So this is exactly what we'll try to do here. I will show you the letters, okay? So we'll divide them into two groups, the vowels and the consonants, and then I will pronounce them, okay? So let's first start with the vowels. And in French, we have six vowels, six voyelles, okay? Six voyelles, and the first one is A, E, I, O, U, Y. Okay, this one is quite tricky for some of you maybe, because maybe in your languages this Y is not a vowel but a consonant. In French it is a vowel. Okay, A, E, I, O, U, Y. Okay, and then let's see the consonant, and we've got 20 consonnes, so 20 consonants, and the first one is B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Z. Okay, so it's B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Z. Okay, so it was just to present you these letters, so the six vowels and a 20 consonant that we do have in French. Don't worry, in the coming videos we will focus on the pronunciation and we'll see how to go combine them and how to pronounce them when we combine them, okay? But then keep them in mind and try to practice on your own, okay? You're
Le visage.
Le nez.
L'œil.
La bouche.
Le menton.
L'oreille.
La joue.
Le front.
Les sourcils.
Les modes et les temps. So basically, when you translated that directly, we're talking about moods and tenses. So basically, like in English, if you want to use a verb, and normally when you will use a verb, you will have to basically decide whether you are using a certain mood and also whether you are using a certain tense for this verb, just because the moods and the tenses will be used in specific context or situations. Okay, so let's see now les modes. Okay, and basically in French we've got the first one that you will use and the first one that we will see together in the coming lessons will be l'indicatif. Okay, and l'indicatif is used to express the reality, so what is really happening. Then we'll have le conditionnel. Okay, so basically, like in English, we will use it to express what we call l'éventualité, something that might happen. Okay, and then we'll have this imperative form as well, so imperative mood, sorry, just to express l'ordre, the order, or then le conseil, advice. And then we'll have this subjonctif, which can be quite tricky, especially at the beginning, because it doesn't exist really in English, and it's to express what we call le sentiment. Okay, so basically we'll have these main moods, so l'indicatif, le conditionnel, l'impératif, and then le subjonctif. It does mean that in all these moods, dans toutes ces modes, you will have different tenses as well. Okay, and that's what we are going to see next, because basically when we're talking about les temps, the tenses, well, I will make it simple, okay, and we'll see in the coming or in the next videos how it will work. But mainly you will express three things with these tenses, and the first one is le présent, okay, the present, then le futur, the future, and then le passé, the past. And we will see that for all these three options, we will have different ways of expressing them. So it does mean that we will have not only three tenses, but much more. Okay, no stress about that, don't worry, we'll do it little by little. So, but just to keep in mind that when we're talking about the tenses, well, we express normally le présent, le futur, and then le passé. Okay, so keep in mind that we get les modes. Okay, so le mode, and you get to decide what mode or what mood, sorry, you will have to use. Indicatif, conditionnel, impératif, or then subjonctif. And the second thing that you have to choose is the correct tense, le temps. And then it's présent, futur, and passé. And in my, as I said, we've got quite many tenses, but we'll see that a bit later.
Le visage.
Le nez.
L'œil.
La bouche.
Le menton.
L'oreille.
La joue.
Le front.
Les sourcils.
Les cheveux.
Les signes diacritiques. And I know that the title is quite scary, and you probably think that, oh, I don't want to watch this video. But trust me, it's quite important for a good reason. And well, basically, what is les signes diacritiques? It's the idea that at one point in the language, we will use un signe, a sign, something that you will add to a letter, and by adding this sign to the letter, it will make a new letter. Okay, and something quite common in French, and we'll see exactly what we are talking about, because even if it's scary, the good news is that we've got only cinq signes diacritiques. Cinq signes diacritiques. And the first one is accent aigu. Okay, the second one is accent grave. Third one is accent circonflexe, then tréma, and last but not least, cédille. Okay, so accent aigu, accent grave, accent circonflexe, tréma, and then cédille. So let's start with l'accent aigu, and it looks like that. Okay, so this is l'accent aigu, and let's see. You will actually put l'accent aigu on the top of E, okay? It doesn't come on the top of A, I, O, U, Y. It's only on E, okay? So keep in mind that l'accent aigu is only coming right here on the top of E, okay? Then you will have l'accent grave, and it goes in the other direction. Okay, but then l'accent grave is actually more used because you can put it on the top of A, on the top of E, and then on the top of U. Alright? After that, you've got l'accent circonflexe, so it's like a little roof here, like a little hat, and it will come on the top of A, E, I, O, and U. Then tréma, just like two little dots here, and it will come on the top of A, E, I, O, and then U. Okay, and the last one, la cédille, if you look carefully, basically it will come right below your C letter. Okay? So remember, l'accent aigu, l'accent grave, l'accent circonflexe, le tréma, la cédille. All right? And the idea, of course, in this video, is only to present these five signs. So in the next lessons, in the next units, I will focus on explaining how to pronounce them, because of course the pronunciation will change. If you put l'accent aigu on the top of E, basically you won't pronounce it like you would pronounce it without the accent. Okay? But then keep in mind that we've got these five signes diacritiques. Accent aigu, accent grave, accent circonflexe, tréma, cédille. Le visage,
les cheveux,
le front,
l'œil,
les yeux,
les sourcils,
l'oreille,
le nez,
la bouche,
la mâchoire,
le menton.
Les ligatures. So even if it's a bit scary, let's start the video. And basically, what are we talking about when we're talking about les ligatures? Well, we're talking about two letters, some strange letters, you might say. This is the first one, and this is the second one. They are quite rare in the French language, but basically you can see them and you need to know what they are, and that's the reason why I've been making this little video. So the first one is this E dans la. Okay, so basically if you translate directly, it's inside or in A. And that's the reason why, because if you look carefully, it's only one letter here, and like if these two letters were glued, okay, or connected like that. So it's E dans la. Let's see a few examples of words that use this E dans la. And the first one is curriculum vitae. Second one is ex aequo. And etc. And then ad vitam aeternam. And so if you look carefully at these words, you realize that this letter is coming directly from Latin. Okay, so and it's quite rare to see this letter in French language. Well, you've got here some examples, but I've been choosing the more common examples, because the other one probably you will never use them, or maybe never encounter them. But anyway, it is rare, but it does exist, and it can be a challenge in some cases for some of you to write this letter correctly. If you want to write it with your computer, because you've got to go through insert and then after that symbol. So basically it's up to you. If you want to write it correctly, you should put, of course, this E dans la. If you don't manage to put it, then just put A and after E. Maybe your computer will correct it automatically. You never know. Okay. The second one is this one, and it's E dans l'eau. So basically the same concept, so E inside O. all right? So because it's only one letter here, and you get this O and A connected, like glued, okay, to each other. So let's see, because this one is actually used a bit more often, and I've been selecting few words, and the first one is un bœuf, un cœur. It's actually quite interesting, because even if you write them differently, you pronounce them the same way. Un œil, un œuf, une sœur. Okay, so un bœuf, un cœur, un œil, un œuf, une sœur. All right, so these words are actually not that rare, and we'll see exactly what they mean. The first one, un bœuf, okay, steer, ox, or then un cœur, heart, un œuf, egg, un cœur, is it choir, choir? I'm not really sure about the pronunciation in English, sorry about that, I don't want to make any mistake. Then we've got un œil, eye, and then une sœur, sister. Okay, and this letter is actually more often used, okay, than the previous one. And then it's, well, basically it will be exactly the same challenge if you want to write it correctly with your computer, whether you try to find this letter by inserting a symbol, okay, or then you just put O, and then after that you will put a, okay? Technically it's a mistake, but then basically if you cannot make in another way, then just write it O and A, okay?
Les directions. À gauche, à droite, en haut, en bas, répétons. À gauche, à droite, en haut, en bas,
le masculin et le féminin, so the masculine and the feminine. And actually, in French, when it comes to grammar, we've got the difference between the masculine form and the feminine form, and we'll see that it will affect quite deeply the language. For instance, we've got, when it comes to les pronoms personnels, we will have the difference between the masculine and the feminine. So we'll start with the feminine, ladies first, and it's elle, okay? So she, so in that case, it is the feminine singular form, elle, okay? For the masculine, it will be il. So in English, it will be he, okay? Il, so in that case, it's the masculine singular form. When it comes to the plural, actually in French we also have the difference between the feminine and the masculine. So basically here, elle, it's the feminine plural form, okay? And then in the same way here, il will be the masculine plural form. So if you look carefully, the only difference between the singular and the plural, it's this final s here. Same thing here between il and il, it's the final S. And if you listen carefully, basically you don't have any differences. So it's L and L. Il and il. Okay, the grammar rule is quite strict in French. If you've got a group of persons and in this group you get at least one man, it will be masculine. Okay, so let's see now if you discover a new word. Okay, so it could be a noun, it could be an adjective. In that case, the good reflex would be to try to see and to try to remember whether it's feminine or whether it's masculine, okay? Because it will basically affect after that, and we'll see that in this video, what will come after. And in most of the cases, we're talking about the adjectives, okay? So it's always good to remember the gender of a word, okay? Of course, in that case, if you're encountering a new noun, so basically you try to remember the gender at the same time. I will make some videos covering the topic and that giving you few tips to try to see, you know, whether it's masculine or feminine according to the ending of the word. In some cases it can help, but in most of the cases you will have to remember gender. Just when you discover a new word, try to remember the gender at the same time. Okay, so for a good reason, and this is now what I will mean, well, basically when you've got a noun, it will actually be connected to an adjective, and whether it's masculine or feminine, basically in French the adjective will be changed also. So let's see an example here. We've got un pays chaud. So if we translate directly, it's un pays, it's a country, and it's chaud is warm, hot. Okay, un pays chaud. So you can see that here pays is masculine, un is the article, the masculine article, un pays chaud. And in that case, your adjective is like that, written at the basic form. So the masculine form is the basic form. And if we take another word like boisson, boisson is feminine. Une boisson. Okay, so here you've got the article and it's the feminine form of the article. Une boisson. And you can see that here your adjective is changing. You will have to put this final e, chaude, okay, at the end, and then the pronunciation will change a little bit. Chaude. So here you pronounce the final b, whereas in the masculine form you don't pronounce it. Okay, all right, so it's just an introduction. Don't worry, in the coming videos I will explain everything, so the articles, the adjective, the way to put the feminine form, everything. So in this video it's just to show you that basically the masculine and the feminine, so whether it's a noun at the masculine and at the feminine, it will affect and then it's also actually possible that the noun, or as we saw, le pronom personnel, will affect the verb. We are talking in that case about what we call compound tenses. So we will cover that probably in unit 4, 5, or 6. Have a look there. We're talking about le passé composé, for instance, so the past tense. And basically, let's have a look there. You will have il est allé. Okay, it's the masculine form here. So aller is to go, and this is the compound tense of il est allé. All right, and then you will have here elle est allée. So basically, he went, she went. All right, and here you can see that you will have the difference between the masculine and the feminine. But don't worry about that, because I will explain that later. It's just to show you that basically the difference in the masculine and the feminine will concern, of course, the subject, so pronom personnel, and then the nouns, but it will also affect what is coming after. So it can be an adjective, as we saw, or it can be a verb. In that case, it's a compound tense, so it's this past tense, le passé composé. All right, so no stress about that. I will explain everything after, okay? Just keep in mind that we've got the difference between the masculine and the feminine. And so my tip for this video will be, when you discover a new word, as I said, try to remember whether it's masculine, or sorry, feminine here, or masculine. Okay, merci beaucoup.
Les points cardinaux. L'ouest. L'est. Le nord. Le sud. Répétons. L'ouest, l'est, le nord, le sud.
Oui et non. Oui et non. So basically, yes and no. Oui et non. So because I thought, you know, it might be useful to make this video. In some situations, I've been assuming that people would understand and would know how to use oui et non, but it's not always the case. And well, basically, I don't expect them to do that. And as I am doing this video and this series of videos for beginners and total beginners, then this is the reason why I thought it might be useful to introduce oui, yes, and then non, no. So basically, when you have a question here, well, in French, you can answer with oui, yes, or then with non, no. It might seem simple, but it's just the way it is. And let's make it quite clear. And that's the reason why we have this question. Vous parlez français? Okay, basically, do you speak French? I just put that in that order because normally it should be verb first and after the subject if we want to construct a correct question. But in many situations, especially when we talk, we can keep the same order. We just need to raise the voice at the end. So, of course, L'Académie Française would like me to put them in the other order, but basically you will hear many French people and many French-speaking people just keep the same order and raise their voice at the end, okay? Vous parlez français? So basically it's a question, do you speak French? And in that case, you've got, well, two possible answers. And if you want to actually answer, in a short way, the first option would be oui or then non. Of course, at one point, and that's the reason why we'll have these videos, you will have the possibility to construct sentences. But basically, if you want to answer shortly, it's not rude. It's quite just you just show that you don't really want to talk that much. But basically, you just answer to the question. So oui, yes, and then non, no. Let's see now how it will work if we have a question, but if this question is at the negative form, okay? Because in that case, it's somehow a bit tricky because strangely for the affirmative answer, it won't be we, but it will become C. And then for the negative, it will be exactly the same. It will be non. Okay, so keep in mind if you get a question, but then this question is at the negative form, then instead of using oui, you will use si, but then non will be the same. Okay, so let's see the same question. Vous ne parlez pas français? So you don't speak French, okay? So this is how it works for the negative form. Don't worry, in few videos I will explain you how it works exactly, okay? But at this point it's only to introduce oui, non, si, non, okay? So it's a negative question in that case. You don't speak French? And the answer would be si, or then non. Obviously, at one point you would like to make sentences instead of using these two possibilities, okay? But it's just to show you that, you know, actually you've got these two options. So if you've got a question, the first one would be oui or then non. If it's a negative question, then it will be si or non, okay?
Les verbes. Sortir du four. Lire le journal. Ramasser ses billes. Servir des bières. Regarder dans une boule de cristal. Souffler dans un sifflet. Cuisiner. Préparer un sandwich. Sortir un pain du four. Couper une meule de fromage. Planter un clou. Couper une planche de bois.
La ponctuation. So let's discover together the punctuation in French. Okay, so we can start. And I thought it might be useful to start with this one. And it's le point. Okay, so le point. And for this video, I will actually tell you how to put these punctuation signs and if we need to put some spaces or not, because it does change a little bit if you compare it to English, for instance. So let's see now, le point. So let's imagine that you will have your sentence, or it could be a word like that, and after that you will put le point, then you will have to put a space and the next word will come, okay? So it could be a sentence before, a sentence after, but the main thing is to remember that you don't have any space before, but you will have one after. Okay, so let's see now the next one, and it's le point virgule. Okay, le point virgule, and le point virgule works like that. Mot numéro un. Then you will put, le point virgule without any space, then a space, and the next word or the rest of the sentence. Okay. La virgule. Okay, so la virgule. And for la virgule, actually, you will have the first word. Then la virgule is coming without any space. Then you will put a space and the rest of the sentence or the next word is coming after. Okay, nothing before, one space after. Le point d'interrogation. Le point d'interrogation. Okay, and in that case, keep in mind that you will have whether your sentence or this word, then, and this is quite important because it does change from other languages, you put a space, you put le point d'interrogation, okay? Then after that, a space, and the rest will follow, okay? So this is quite important. Remember that we will put in French a space before le point d'interrogation, because it's not the case in, well, some other languages, okay? And now, le point d'exclamation. Okay, so le point d'exclamation, you will have your sentence and then the previous word. Then, un espace, space. Then, you will put your point d'exclamation here. After that, a space, and the next word is coming. Same thing as we had for le point d'interrogation. Remember that you will have to put a space before. Les deux points, okay, les deux points, and then they work like that, le mot, then you will have to put space, les deux points are coming right after, another space after, then the rest will come, okay, so remember, one space before, one space after. Les guillemets, okay, les guillemets. And concerning les guillemets, actually, it will go like that. So you will have your sentence or, well, the previous word, then a space, then the first one. After that, a space, then you put what you want to put between them. Another space, guillemets again, space, and the rest of the sentence or the next word or whatever you want here. But you've got to keep in mind that here it's quite tricky. Space, then guillemets, space, what you put between, space, guillemets, space, and what comes after. Les points de suspension. Les points de suspension. And regarding les points de suspension, it will come like that. So what comes before, le mot, or then the sentence, and then les points de suspension, space, and then the next word or what comes after the sentence if you want. Okay, so nothing before, a space after. Les parenthèses, okay, and regarding les parenthèses, well, the first word, then you will put a space, then the first part, so la première parenthèse, your word, or then group of words, fermez la parenthèse, then you will put a space, and after that, the next part is coming. Okay, so remember, before and after, nothing between. Okay?
Un policier. Des amoureux. Des automobilistes. Un cow-boy. Un cavalier. Un fou. Une écolière. Un inspecteur. Un réalisateur. Une danseuse.
Les verbes. Faire le ménage. Préparer une pizza. Prendre des mesures. Servir un plat. Travailler. Servir à boire. Peindre. Mener une enquête. Lire. Confectionner une robe. Faire de la pâtisserie. Couper les cheveux.
Écrire en français. So write in French. And well, I thought it might be useful to just make this little video because I've been teaching for quite many years now, and I've been noticing that at one point my students tend to be a bit disappointed or sad because they just realized one important thing in French, and it's the difference between what je prononce, I pronounce, and j'écris, I write. Because basically you can see that, of course, you will have some connections between what you pronounce and what you write, but we've got many, many things that we will have to write and we won't pronounce. I thought it might be useful to start and give you an example here with the verb parler. Okay, so we will make the conjugation. Remember that we will focus on the conjugation in another video that will come a bit later. Okay, but it's just to give you a good example here. So parler is to speak or to talk, and it's a regular verb, so it belongs to the first group ending with er. So let's see how we conjugate it at the present tense. Je parle. Tu parles, il, elle parle, nous parlons, vous parlez, il, elle parle. Okay, so basically you get here this je, and it's I, je parle, I talk, I speak, tu, and tu is for you, okay, and it's the singular form, tu parles here, you talk, you speak, il, it's for the masculine form, he, il, and then elle, feminine form, she, elle. Okay, so il, elle, and then we've got the same form, parle. Then comes the plural form, nous, so oui, okay, and in that case it's nous parlons, vous, you, so it's the plural form. Or then we will see a bit later that it can be also for the singular if it's the polite form. Okay, vous parlez. And then we've got il, so they, but then in French we divide and we make the difference between the masculine plural, so il here, and elle, the feminine plural. Il, elle parle. All right, so we get je parle. Tu parles, il parle, elle parle, nous parlons, vous parlez,
Il parle, elle parle. And if you look carefully, you write it with E here, E-S, E, then you get E-N-T here. So I only take these four forms just for a good reason. It's just because if you look carefully and if you listen to me, I will pronounce it je parle, tu parles, il parle, elle parle, il parle, elle parle. So it does mean that even if you write them differently, E, ES, and then ENT, you will pronounce them the same way. And this is basically the difficult thing about French language. It's just the big difference between what you say, what you pronounce, and what you write. Okay, so in this example, for this verb, actually, if we finish it like that, you can see that you've got three phonetical forms. The first one is parle, okay, the yellow one. Then you've got nous parlons, and then you've got vous parlez. But of course, at one point, if you want to write it correctly, you will have to remember the endings, and you will have to put this S here, for instance, if you want to write it correctly, or then ENT here, even if you pronounce them the same way. Okay, so my advice would be, if you want to be happy, well, basically, when you see, it's coming, yeah, when you see a new word, a nouveau mot, well, word in general, so it can be a verb, it can be an adjective, it can be a noun, whatever. When you see a new word, try to remember, of course, how you will pronounce it, but then try also to remember how to write it correctly. Petit personnage. Une chirurgienne. Un chirurgien. Une avocate. Un juge. Un maître nageur. Une danseuse. Un chimiste. Un rocker. Un politicien. Un équilibriste. Un agent secret. Une actrice. Une sportive. Un garde du corps. Un ange. Un chèque. Un archéologue. Un architecte. Un aventurier. Un militaire. Un peintre. Une coiffeuse. Un cuisinier.
Une danseuse. Un joueur de banjo. Un barbier. Des vacanciers. Un professeur. Une babysitter. Un aveugle. Un sportif. Un joueur de baseball. Un garçon qui dessine. Un footballeur. Des scouts. Un maçon. Un voleur. Des collègues. Des copines. Un boucher. Un domestique. Un serveur. Un ébéniste. Une fille qui dessine. Un joueur de tam-tam. Un couple préhistorique. Un conducteur de char. Des personnes âgées. Un musicien. Un fakir. Une pom-pom girl. Une cuisinière. Un clown. Un étudiant. Une ouvrière. Un chanteur. Un scaphandrier. Un docteur. Un sorcier. Des paysans. Un esquimau. Un bourreau. Des pique-niqueurs. Des fermiers. Un agriculteur. Une infirmière. Une maître nageuse. Une surfeuse. Une plongeuse. Une nageuse. Un violoniste. Un pompier. Un politicien. Un jardinier. Une lectrice. Une acrobate. Une cycliste. Une vaïnée. Une marchande de glace. Une adolescente. Une écolière. Une patineuse. Un guerrier. Une femme âgée. Des musiciens. Des plongeurs. Un peintre en bâtiment. Un adolescent. Une voyante. Une campeuse. Une mécanicienne. Un modéliste. Un campeur. Un professeur. Un balayeur. Un juge. Un juge. Un jongleur. Un roi. Des joueurs de Scrabble. Un fumeur. Une présentatrice. Une bibliothécaire. Un maître nageur. Un pianiste. Un bûcheron. Un magicien. Un détective. Une femme de chambre. Un livreur. Un facteur. Un malade. Un travailleur à la chaîne. Un déménageur. Un lecteur. Un couple. Un joueur de maracas. Un guitariste. Un trompettiste. Un génie. Un mécanicien. Un plongeur. Un militaire. Un livreur de lait. Un mime. Un garagiste. Thank you. Un homme invisible. Un Amérindien. Une Amérindienne. Un snowboarder. Un skieur. Des danseurs. Un chanteur d'opéra. Un Égyptien. Un pirate. Un plombier. Un président. Une princesse. Un détective. Un professeur. Un psychologue. Une reine. Un chanteur. Un rasta. Un homme chauve. Un rocker. Un patineur. Un grec. Un couvreur. Un super-héros. Un marin. Un samouraï. Le Père Noël. Un cancre. Une institutrice. Un philosophe grec. Une plongeuse. Un garde du corps. Un sommelier. Un écrivain. Un malade. Un astronaute. Un coureur. Un karatéka. Un joueur de frisbee. Un plongeur. Un tailleur. Un couturier. Un présentateur de télévision. Un cycliste. Des amoureux sur un banc. Une équilibriste. Un guitariste. Un photographe. Un trapéziste. Un agent secret. Un reporter. Un guerrier. Un baigneur. Un journaliste. Un vétérinaire. Un serveur. Un sorcier. Une artiste peintre. Une joueuse de badminton. Une cycliste. Une sage-femme. Une femme enceinte. Une sculptrice. Une employée de bureau. Une femme qui se maquille. Une architecte. Une femme avec les yeux bandés. Un serveur. Un guerrier. Une randonneuse. Elle est furieuse. Elle est en larmes. Elle est rieuse. Elle est souriante. Elle est déçue. Elle est choquée. Elle est espiègle. Elle est complice. Elle est heureuse. Il joue du violon. Il a mis un masque. Il est heureux. Il fait une confidence. Il fait de la boxe. Il joue au docteur. Il fait de la moto. Il joue du saxophone. Il est incognito. Il se repose sur le fauteuil. Il a bien mangé. Il joue de la trompette. Il fait de l'escrime. Il joue aux mousquetaires.
Il est surpris. Il est déçu. Il est contrarié. Il est étonné. Il est perplexe. Il est heureux. Il est farceur. Il est choqué. Il fait un clin d'œil. Il est heureux. Il fait la tête. Il tire la langue. Il est triste. Il est soucieux. Il est content. Il est choqué. Il fait un clin d'œil. Il est pensif. Il fait un clin d'œil. Il porte une auréole. Il ouvre la bouche. Il sourit. Il est préoccupé. Il est étonné. Il tire la langue. Il réfléchit. Il ne se sent pas bien. Il a du chagrin. Il rougit de honte. Il sourit de toutes ses dents. Il est très gêné. Il a un sourire crispé. Un ver de terre. Un chien. Un bison. Une souris. Un dromadaire. Un corbeau. Une vache. Un crabe. Un chien, des éléphants, un requin. Un chat, une poule, un hamster, un cheval, une huître, une vache, un crocodile, un chevreuil. Un canard. Un renard. Un éléphant. Un poisson. Un poisson. Un flamant rose. Une grenouille. Des girafes. Des hippopotames. Un cheval. Un colibri. Une méduse. Une dinde. Des kangourous. Un hippopotame. Un kiwi. Un koala. Un poisson. Un homard. Un chien. Un singe. Un élan. Une taupe. Une oie.